This is Match Game 74, and it's production number 0253, and we'll take one. Get ready to match the stars. Scoey Mitchell. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Eddie Deutsch. Richard Dawson. And Marcia Wallace. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Boy, before you say anything.
Sure, puts a lot of pink in your cheek.
What? Before you say anything, I must point out, Gene always knows when he has enough. He falls down.
There goes myself. Your back again, honey.
That's a dumb thing to do. No, how are you?
Oh, we're fine.
Much better than
yeah,
you.
Yeah, terrific. You know why I did that?
No.
Because
no,
I just found out a couple seconds before we came out here that this show plays in Ogden, Utah at 7:30 in the morning, and I fell right down, and then he says, here's Gene Rivers, and I rolled down the stairs. Hello, players. Here's Carlotta Nelson and Judy Pagano. How are you, ladies? We know that Carlotta Nelson's the current champ. She's got $4,050 to her credit, and she's very happy about that. And she is now going to be challenged by this lady, whom we shall hear something about now.
Well, I'm a housewife. I've been married for 10 years, and I have two children, Lori and Mike.
Okay, good luck to you, Judy. You ready?
Yes, I am.
We'll be ready right after we have this message of interest. Hello there. Now, we're all ready? Push button. Ask challenger, make selection.
B, please.
B. You say B. I have B, and I will read this to you.
You Gibbon said...
Oh, my God! He said, I had a terrible nightmare.
Sounds like he's Dr. Frankenstein.
I dreamed a giant blank ate me. Yul Gibbons said that. I had a terrible nightmare. I dreamed a giant blank ate me. Think about that, Judy.
While everybody's finishing up, I would like to make one public announcement.
What is that?
Charles Nelson Reilly has been wearing socks the entire week.
Well.
The same ones.
The same ones. All right.
And now, we know because we sit on the second tier.
Okay.
They're basic black.
That's right. All right.
They weren't when we started.
You know, here we go.
Come on now. Cool.
I'm fine. I'm just sitting here.
Judy Pagano is going to give us a response now. Yul Gibbons said, I had a terrible nightmare. I dreamed a giant blank ate me.
A giant tree.
A giant tree? Really? Did Yul Gibbons ever eat a giant tree?
No, but he eats the nuts off of them.
He eats the nuts off the trees. All right, she said a giant tree. And here we go, Scoey. I'm sorry to... I'm not picking on you or anything like that, Scoey, but
sock
you're first.
In, Sco, baby.
Yeah. She said tree.
Oh, golly.
Another loser, is it?
No, I was trying to be funny. You know, I said prune. It's sort of like a running gag.
Okay. A giant prune ate me.
That's an excellent answer.
That's an excellent answer. That's
wrong
right.
Again, as usual, yeah, but getting near.
That's right. Getting close. What do you say,
getting
Brad?
Getting near to what? Well, I, you know, he's always eating that terrific cereal. There are many edible things. And then he says, I said a giant grape nut.
A giant grape nut. He said that. Okay. Charles, what did you say?
I chose a pretty dandelion.
A giant dandelion ate me.
Lousy is the other two.
That's one, sir. Mine was a good one.
Yeah. Okay. going from the ridiculous to the BMT, here's Patty Deutsch.
Change of patch, all, yes. Yep. I said that he was eaten by a giant weed.
Yul Gibbons said it. Dreamed a giant weed ate me.
Well, he eats weeds.
He eats weeds?
He eats anything.
Really? Yeah, okay.
He don't care what happened to him.
No, that's why he's living so long. What do you say there, Richard?
Well, Yul Gibbons eats nuts all the time.
Hickory nuts?
Hickory nuts. And all of the time. And what other little thing eats nuts?
Squirrels. Really? Is that what you got?
Great big giant squirrel.
Oh, a squirrel. Oh. Okay. He's English. You're so logical, aren't they, Marcia, there? Why?
Well,
why are you paying...
You see, Scoy, after this answer, they'll never bother you again. I was thinking about all the things that Yul Gibbons refuses to eat that are bad for you, that are bad for all of us. So I said he was eaten by a giant Twinkie.
You're right, Scoy. We love you, Scoy. You just got automatically booked.
Oh, I'll definitely be back.
Yeah. Well, I tell you, you can put the prunes away now. We don't need the prunes anymore.
I thought it was a pretty good answer.
Yes.
Well, honey, you don't hang on to them no matter how terrific okay. they are. We just throw them
so
right
that
in.
That is that, and now this is this. Are you ready? This is for Collada. Everybody plays. Prize fighter said, I hate to box Charles Nelson Reilly. Whenever we get into a clinch, he blanks my ear.
That had to come right after my dandelion number.
All right. Did you hear that, Colin? The prize fighter said, I hate to box Charles Nelson Reilly. Whenever we get into a clinch, he blanks my ear. Richard Dawson was a professional fighter at one time. Did you know that?
I didn't know that.
Yes, just for one fight.
1 hour and a half.
Two jokes in one mind. Okay, everybody's ready, and we'll call on Carlotta. Prize fighter said, I hate to box Charles Nelson Reilly. Whenever we get into a clinch, he blanks my ear.
Kisses.
Really? Kisses my ear.
Well, I thought Scoey had it this time.
You mean Scoey hasn't got it?
Well, I may have it. It depends on how liberal the judges are.
Well, all right. The judge is over there.
If it's prunes my ear, they're not going
to. All right, Scoey, you're on.
How can he see what I wrote? I said blows in it.
Blows in my ear.
That's sort of like kissing.
Yeah, well, the audience loves it. The judge hated it. I'm sorry about that.
Get Scoey. The money, Mama.
Brett?
I love that line.
I figure as long as you're not belting somebody in the ear, it comes close to kissing. I'm on your side, sweetheart.
Yeah.
I said tickles.
He tickles my ear.
Oh, honey, don't be hateful.
It's hard to do that with boxing gloves on. Shall we demonstrate?
Well, who said he was doing it with boxing gloves?
Oh, I see. Well, the prize fighter, Charles.
I said bites.
Bites.
Hang in there, Mama.
He said that with a twinkle in his eye. He bites. I love the twinkle in your eye. Oh, you jolly old St. Nick. He was St. Nick last Christmas. Well, anyway, Patty.
Yes.
What do you say?
I said that he nibbles his ear.
I hate to box Charles Nelson Reilly. When are we going to clinch? He nibbles my ear. Yes. And what do you say?
Well, I boxed Charles Nelson Reilly once.
Yes?
And sent him to Hong Kong. Yes, he does kiss your ear.
Kisses!
That does not make you a bad boxer.
Right.
Reprieve, reprieve.
Kisses! There you go. Well, you got two there. So at the end of round one, the score is 2-0 in favor of the current champ, Carlotta Nelson. We'll be back with round two in a moment or so, but now this for you. Now, we're ready to carry on with round two, and I'll push a button to reveal the round two of final round questions. Ask Judy to make a selection.
Try B again.
B again. All right. You didn't match anybody the first time. That means everybody plays in the second round. Sally lost her blank in the bathtub. Sally lost her blank in the bathtub.
I know where I lost mine, but I suppose it's not related, is it?
Who wants to bring up the First World War?
They really like each other, Scoey. Huh? They really like each
other. Hey, I'm having problems. Well, you don't. I'm trying to get an answer.
All right, okay. I won't bother you, Scoey. Sally lost her blanket. There. Does it help you? There.
He don't read.
I know a guy, I can read the blank.
Sally lost her blank in the bathtub. Bottom tier is just about ready. Yes, they are ready. Now, Scoey's trying real hard. Leave him alone. He's got a winner this time.
I haven't said a word to the little devil.
All right.
That's why he's been losing.
Judy Pagano. Sally lost her blank in the bathtub.
Her virtue.
Her virtue? She said Sally lost her virtue in the bathtub. Now, you've got a bunch of sophisticated show business people here.
Well, I'll be doggone.
You'd be doggone? She said she lost her virtue in the bathtub.
Now, that was the first thing I thought of, and I said, no, she'd never think of that.
That little girl would never think of that.
I'm afraid we won't buy that, Scoey. Show us your answer.
So.
I feel so sorry for him.
Scoey, you just set a new world's record, new champ on Match Game for consecutive wrong answers.
Scoey, we once had that seat empty and that got two correct answers.
That's right.
Scoey, I'm trying.
You are trying, and you're a warm-hearted, lovable person.
Honest, I thought of the word virtue, and then I looked at her and I said, you know, such a clean-looking face. And
yeah.
Right. She'd never think of that.
Right, she wouldn't. But apparently she's been thinking about it. So, come to my dressing room after the show, and we'll talk. Now, Brett, it's your turn.
It's amazing how people get fooled by pink, isn't it?
Yes, it is. She's wearing pink.
I've worn it myself upon occasion. Never fooled anybody, but it's worth a try. Did you say virtue?
Virtue's what she said.
Good heavens, it must have been an enormous top. Yes. I said innocence.
Innocence and virtue is a match. Okay. They do make enormous bathtubs, Charles.
The size of the tub has nothing to do with it.
How would you know?
Call it, Al. Show and tell.
I said virginity.
Same thing. Where's another match for you? Okay. Hello there, sweet little innocent girl. You wouldn't say an answer like that, would you?
No, I've
Sally lost her virtue in the bathtub.
No, I've led a very sheltered life.
You have. What did you say?
I said ducky.
Her ducky.
Another name for it.
I'd like to show you my bathtub sometime. All right, Richard.
Well, Judy, you won't believe this. First thing I thought of was soap. And then I thought of virtue.
Marcia.
Jane.
Marcia.
Well, since I'm saving myself for my husband.
if that were true.
Rubber duck.
Rubber duck, yeah. Okay. So that was three for you, Judy. And now you've got two. And as we come to this question here, I point out to you, you need one to tie, two to win. All right, here we go. Long John Silver said,
Aye, that new pirate has a mighty weird dog. That dog tried to blank my wooden leg. New pirate has a mighty weird dog. That dog tried to blank my wooden leg. You play you and you, but not you or you.
You definitely... Isn't it wonderful the way Scoey always gets to play?
That's right. He likes to participate. Long John Silver. You all know Long John Silver. It's an easy one. Come on now. There's some...
Well, of course. There are some terrific answers. I'm just trying to phrase it properly.
That's not one of them, is it?
I make no judgments here.
It's my job to make judgments
Charles?
The world.
Could you read it once more,
yes,
please?
Yes, Long John Silver said, Aye, that new pirate has a mighty weird dog. That dog tried to blank my wooden leg. Did that help?
Easy.
He's got one. By Jove, he's got one. Okay, now we'll call on Carlotta.
Long John Silver said, "I, that new pirate, has a mighty weird dog. That dog tried to blank my wooden leg."
Bite.
Bite. What's wrong with that? That's good. Don't boo her. She's won over $4,000. Bite is good, fetch is good, and all that stuff. Scoey, what do you say?
I got one.
You got one?
If the judges are still liberal. I said chew.
Chew and bite? All right, so at this moment, the score is tied. One more bite out of that wooden leg, and you win the game. Brett?
Do you know I'm all teared up about Scully?
Yes.
Thrilled for mine. I don't know whether I can give my answer or not.
Yeah, what have you got?
I said use it as a tree.
All right. Very delicately said, too, my dear Charles.
Moving on in the delicacy area, I said tinkle on mine.
All right. Well, the score is still tied. We're going to find out from Patty Deutsch if she unties it or if we end up as a tie. What do you say?
Why is it always up to me to bring the level of the program back up again? I said bite.
Come on down. Another 100. Judy, we've got to say goodbye to you. We've got a gift for you. I've enjoyed meeting you.
It's been a lot of fun.
Good. Thank you very much. Judy Pagano, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye. Goodbye, Judy. We've got to stand by here for a moment or so, and I'll hang on to you so you don't fall over in a dead faint here. You've won $4,150. We got a message of interest for one and all gathered here today. Here we are again. With Carlotta Nelson. How many times now?
Four.
Four is right. All right.
Good.
Gonna try for over $5,000. Shall we have a go?
Yes.
We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Blank crab, C-R-A-B. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500. And the second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Which celebrities do you want a little assist from?
Richard.
What is it?
Cracked crab.
Oh, well.
Cracked crab. Okay, there's one.
Charles.
Long Island crab.
Long Island crab. Okay.
Scoey.
Scoey.
Old.
Old crab. So you got old crab, Long Island crab, and cracked crab. You may choose one of those winners. Or think up one of your own. What would you like to do?
Sand.
Sand crab. That's what you want to say. Okay, she says sand crab. She's on her own, and that's her decision, and it's entirely up to her. We're looking for sand crab. May we see the $100 response? Buster crab. They didn't know how to spell his name, did they? All right, we're looking for sand crab. Here is the $250 response. You old crab. Well, Scully said that. That would have won, wouldn't it? All right, last chance for sand crab. King crab. Oh. Well, listen, you picked up another 100.
She'll learn to stick with me before.
That's right. That's right. You've got to go with a winner every time.
That was a hard one.
So, yeah, that was a hard one. So you're up to $4,150, and you're going to meet another player. Here comes Susan Warren. Want to step back up there, Susan? You know Carlotta. And now, Susan, would you tell us a little bit about yourself, if you please?
Well, I'm the admissions statistician for Pepperdine University at Malibu, and my husband is a graduate student there working on his master's and his teaching credentials, and he's almost through.
Terrific.
So I'm really glad.
All right. Shall we begin? All right. I'll push a button and ask you to make a decision, Susan, A or B?
I'll pick B.
B is what she wants. Everybody plays. Hey, I got a TV guide listing for you. Tuesday night, ABC, Marcus Welby, M.D. Dr. Welby goes to Las Vegas, gets drunk, and blanks a topless waitress. What's your TV guide listing then? Do it as fast as you can. We're getting near the end.
TV guide listing, Tuesday night, ABC, Marcus Welby, MB, MB, MD. Dr. Welby goes to Las Vegas, gets drunk, and blanks a topless waitress. Do it quickly, Charles. You're finished down here. You're the best. All right. Put it in the slot, and away we go. Now we'll get a response from Susan. Tuesday night, ABC, Marcus Welby, MD. Dr. Welby goes to Las Vegas, gets drunk, and blanks a topless waitress.
Operates on
a topless waitress. Said operates on a topless waitress. What do you say, Scoey?
I'm sort of getting the hang of the game now. Operates on.
And a boy, there's one for you.
Let's go.
What do you say, Brett?
Grabs
a topless waitress. All right, Charles?
I said examines a topless waitress.
Examines. That is not an operation. Do you offer an operation?
No, I offer a healing.
Heals. Okay, Richard?
I happen to know the hamburger married a topless.
Married a... And Marcia.
Well, he bandaged her up.
He bandaged her up. So you picked up one there, and your first round question comes up later, but right now this comes up. Hello there. Just time to say goodbye, right? Goodbye,
goodbye
all.
Goodbye. Oh, goodbye.
Join us next.
This is Johnny Olsen speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Travel Tales next over most of these CBS stations.